guys, welcome back to my vlog. Today I'm starting off the vlog very late. It is currently Friday, but you guys will see this on Diwali day, and I'll have a Diwali vlog coming for you guys on Monday. Wow, that was a lot. It's currently 2 o'clock. I'm now starting off this vlog, but I have some clips of Thursday with my mom, my sister-in-law, and myself, who was making sweets. So if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I wasn't active too much on Thursday. So yeah, your girl was busy and dead tired. I woke up like 11 o'clock, order pizza, ate, and then decide, okay, I'm gonna deep clean. Like, when I mean deep clean, like just mop out, because my place is already pretty clean. So I'm just mopping out, and then I'm going to shower and fix my hair, do something with it. Maybe I might flat iron it, because I haven't done that in like months. So yeah, I'm gonna throw in those clips from Thursday for you guys to see what we did, and if there's anything, I'll catch back with you in a bit.
We will use happy measurement.
Right, so you just use 4.
Yes.
All right. So we have lychee, ginger, cream, powder milk. So if you don't want to sift it, you could use your food processor.
Yes, it's plenty easier. Mm-hmm. But you know, on TV, they wouldn't tell you to use your food processor. They don't want you to do the old-fashioned way.
On my channel, I will tell you to use your food processor.
And then they will come and say, Madam, why are you making things easy for?
I know, I'm not following tradition and things.
Yes.
Following a recipe called cooking with Natasha. Are
you touching?
You're probably seeing lumps.
To make barfi. Okay, right. So she pour it in her tray.
Mm-hmm.
Well, because she pressing it out.
This is plenty.
So that the steam presses through. Okay,
I feel this one didn't eat anything, you know, it too.
You
don't find it too thick?
So take some ghee and rub it in your hand.
Yes. You don't find this too thick in here?
No, I find it good. You don't want a tin barfi.
Give me some ghee.
You want to get a tin piece of barfi.
Yeah. You rub some ghee in your hand?
Yeah, and then you press it.
Pressing?
Keep pressing until it's smooth. So you could come closer to check the technique. The red woman. Is it red woman barfi? Oh yeah, but see a Spaniel make barfi. So we're gonna make Denise's famous gulab jamun, but I'm mixing it this year. So we have, tell them what you're doing.
We have condensed milk. Get me a microphone. We have condensed milk. We have butter, a whole, one butter, a little of, let me say a teaspoon of lychee, ginger to taste. So we really have ginger to taste the water. Yeah, have to take it with your hand and mix it now. Great, like how it is great, your husband. Let me see how it is great. Ooh, and it had a color almost like your husband. So even better yet.
Oh, that sounds so good.
That had to melt in your hands, eh? So the warmer your hands is?
Well, I hot, so this going to melt now.
Let me see. Three cups of flour.
So we mix in this to what consistency?
To a lawyer, a soft lawyer. Like a bus of
shop lawyer. Tell the people if they don't know what lawyer means.
Okay, you're kneading it like a roti dough. You're forming like a roti dough with the milk and the butter, the lychee and the ginger. You're putting enough flour, like 3 cups of flour to 1 condensed milk and a butter. And you're making it form till a light dough. You should get about 3 to 4 lawyers with it. Well, dough. Like roti dough.
So you add any liquid to this?
No liquid. I have no liquid.
So you don't have to add no milk to make this dough?
No. The milk is just the condensed milk and...
So basically the water to bind the dough is the condensed milk?
The condensed milk.
Okay.
That is why you just get that richness. No sugar, nothing. When you need enough.
So the condensed milk is your sweetener?
Yes.
This is gula jamun or kurma?
Gula. So now you can start putting at a time. Coming in, coconut barfi.
We in a race.
Everything
is
good.
Yeah.
The barfi was the last.
You come all